Today lecture about jaundice or icterus. Jaundice is defined as the yellowish pigmentation of skin and mucous membranes, especially conjunctiva and sclera, as a consequence of increased blood bilirubin level. There are two forms of bilirubin in the blood circulation, which are direct or conjugated and indirect or unconjugated bilirubin. The increase of any one of them result in the increase in the total bilirubin level, which cause the yellowish color of skin. Normally, total bilirubin level in adult animals is below 1 mg/dL. Jaundice occurs when the total bilirubin level becomes above 3 mg/dL. Bilirubin metabolism. As we know, red blood cells have a lifespan in the blood circulation. For example, the lifespan for the red blood cells in flying is 70 days, in equine is 145 days, and in bovine 150 days. So when the red blood cells become aged or old red blood cells, the red blood cells is removed from the circulation by the reticuloendothelial cells. In the reticuloendothelial cells, the hemoglobin is split into globin and heme. The heme is split also into iron and bilirubin. The globin and iron are utilized for synthesis of red blood cells. However, the bilirubin, which is insoluble in water, is transported in the blood circulation by the two albumin, which albumin act as a carrier for the bilirubin. First, the attachment between bilirubin and albumin prevent the loss of the bilirubin in the urine, because albumin is not passed through the glomerular filter line. Also, the combination bilirubin and albumin is called indirect bilirubin. The indirect bilirubin is transported to the liver, and inside the hepatocytes, the indirect or unconjugated bilirubin is conjugated with glucuronic acid, which results in the formation of direct bilirubin or conjugated bilirubin. The hepatocyte secrete the direct bilirubin in the bile canaliculi, which then reach to the main bile duct and then to the intestine. In the intestine, the direct bilirubin has three pathways. The first pathway, direct bilirubin, is returned to the liver through the enteric hepatic circulation. Another part is secreted in feces in the form of stercopyrenogen, and the third part is reaches to the blood circulation and excreted in urine as uropyrenogen. This represents the normal bilirubin metabolism inside the body. When total bilirubin increased above 3 mg/dL, the result will be jaundice or icterus, which means yellowish coloration of skin and mucous membrane due to high level of bilirubin in the blood circulation. The total bilirubin is equal to the sum of the indirect bilirubin plus the direct bilirubin. Both total bilirubin and direct bilirubin are measured in serum samples, and then indirect bilirubin are calculated by subtracting direct bilirubin from total bilirubin. Types of jaundice. Jaundice is classified into three types: prehepatic jaundice, hepatic jaundice, and posthepatic jaundice. The prehepatic jaundice are called the hemolytic jaundice. This type of jaundice occurs due to excessive destruction of red blood cells. Excessive destruction of red blood cells will result in increased the bilirubin levels in the blood circulation. And as we know, bilirubin is carried in the blood attached to albumin, and this combination is known as indirect bilirubin. This means that increased the level of the indirect bilirubin in the blood circulation. This means that the uptake of the bilirubin from the blood circulation is increased, which in turn result in also increase the level of the direct bilirubin excreted into the intestine. The direct bilirubin in the intestine, as we said before, has three pathways. The first pathway is the enterohepatic circulation. The second pathway is excreted in the feces in the form of steatopyrinology, which was also increased. And the third pathway is direct bilirubin is excreted through the kidney in the form of uropyrinology. So what happened in case of prehepatic jaundice? First, the dominant bilirubin in the blood circulation is the unconjugated bilirubin, which is also associated with increase of for the direct bilirubin, but the dominant is the indirect bilirubin. Second, the color of feces become dark brown to orange in color due to increased level of steatopyrinology in the feces. Also, hemolytic jaundice characterized by higher level of uropyrinology in the urine. Rehepatic jaundice, first indirect bilirubin is the dominant bilirubin in the blood, neuropyrinogen increased in urine, the color of feces is dark orange due to excess of steatopyrinogen. As a rule, indirect bilirubin not secreted in urine because it is bound to albumin. Hepatic jaundice, which occur in cases of disease of the liver. The lifespan of red blood cells is normal. The bilirubin is formed in a normal pathway, combined to albumin, transported in the form of indirect bilirubin to the liver. Inside the liver, the indirect bilirubin is conjugated with glucuronic acid, which results in the formation of direct bilirubin or conjugated bilirubin. Blessings of liver disease result in decrease the amount of indirect bilirubin taken by the liver, which result in increase the indirect bilirubin in the blood circulation. Also, the increase the level of the direct bilirubin due to part from the direct bilirubin formed inside the hepatocyte is returned again to the blood circulation due to the intrahepatic cholestasis. The presence of direct bilirubin in the blood in higher level, direct bilirubin will excrete it in urine, which result in dark brownish coloration in the color of urine, which is characteristic for hepatitis. Direct bilirubin is excreted in the intestine, and then, as we said before, has three pathway. The first pathway is to return in the liver in the form of enterohepatic circulation, and also this part represent another cause for the higher level of the direct bilirubin in the blood circulation. Secondly, the direct bilirubin is excreted in feces, so the color of feces here is normal. Feces not change due to the amount of steatopyrinology, no increase. After that, the uropyrinology, and the third part is excreted through the kidney in the form of uropyrinology. From this diagram, the cause of hepatic jaundice is presence of liver disease. Hepatic jaundice is characterized by increase the indirect bilirubin in the blood circulation, increase the direct bilirubin due to the intrahepatic cholestasis and the enterohepatic circulation, Also, the normal stercobiological level, normal yellow-biological level. The increased level of direct hemoglobin in the blood, which is excreted in urine, result in dark brownish coloration of the urine. Hepatic jaundice, both direct and indirect hemoglobin increased in the blood. Increase in total hemoglobin mainly due to increase in both direct and indirect hemoglobin. Direct hemoglobin is excreted in urine and results in change the color of urine to dark brownish, normal urobilinogen level. Most hepatic jaundice or obstructive jaundice. Normal red blood cells lifespan, all the red blood cells is removed by the reticuloendothelial cells, result in the formation of bilirubin. Bilirubin is carried in the blood circulation attached to albumin, which result in the formation of indirect hemoglobin. Indirect hemoglobin leaches to the liver and the inside the hepatocyte, conjugated with glucuronic acid, and result in the formation of direct hemoglobin. Direct hemoglobin is excreted in the small intestine. The most hepatic jaundice is called obstructive jaundice. This means there is an obstruction in the main bile duct, which present the excretion of the direct hemoglobin in the small intestine. This result in increased direct hemoglobin in the bile canaliculi in the main bile duct, increase the direct hemoglobin in the main bile duct and in the bile canaliculi, which also result in increased direct hemoglobin in the blood circulation. The direct hemoglobin excreted in urine and result in the dark brownish coloration of the urine. Also, this means that no bile pigment in the intestine. This means no enterohepatic circulation, no uropyrinogen excreted in urine, no stercopyrinogen. So, no enterohepatic circulation, no direct hemoglobin excreted in feces, which result in gray colored feces, and no direct hemoglobin excreted in the urine, which result in absence of uropyrinogen. Most hepatic jaundice, direct hemoglobin is the main hemoglobin in the circulation. Direct hemoglobin excreted in urine and gives the urine dark brownish color. Uropyrinogen is absent in urine. Conclusion: direct hemoglobin is excreted in urine in hepatic and obstructive jaundice. Uropyrinogen is absent from urine in obstructive jaundice. Both direct and indirect hemoglobin increased in hepatic jaundice. Indirect hemoglobin is dominant in blood in cases of prehepatic jaundice. Direct hemoglobin is dominant in blood in cases of obstructive jaundice.